Welcome to Facilitate. We want to introduce smart polymer platform for advanced cell and tissue culture applications. This video is about connecting cells into 3D spheroids and their potential in research and preclinical applications. We all know how frustrating it is to stay alone or to have only contact with one or two people in our environment, and we are all tired of social distancing, and for cells it's the same. So they don't want to be far away from each other. Preferably the cells like to be in contact with each other and to form a dense network. And today we want to talk about the importance of these connections in reliable cell cultural model systems for preclinical applications. Reliable model systems are urgently needed. For example, around 10 million people died due to cancer per year. Model systems which allow us to model the disease and to get new insights about the origin of the diseases can help to find new drugs and help to decrease the number of deaths. But also the COVID-19 situation taught us the importance of fast drug development and fortified the role of model systems to fight against infectious diseases. Such model systems are used in drug development and to screen new drugs or to check the drug safety. Currently, animal model systems are used as standard model systems in preclinical studies accepting the species differences. For example, animal cells show different cell behavior and different expression profiles in comparison to human cells. And this has a big impact on the predictability of the results. Further, such animal models are not usable for wide-scale drug screening. They're expensive and they need a lot of time. And another thing is that they are limited available, and according to the international regulations of the 3R ethical guidelines, animal testing should be replaced, reduced, and refined. Implementation of in vitro systems in preclinical studies can bridge the gap between animal studies and humans. So some of the systems are still limited in predictability, but it's possible with such in vitro models to screen drugs in a wide scale. In vitro systems are cheap, so they reduce the cost and the duration time of drug screenings, and in vitro models can reduce animal studies and maybe someday replace them. Currently, in vitro models can be used for different applications. They can be used for disease modeling to understand the origin and the progression of diseases on molecular and cellular level. And the results from such models can be implemented into further drug development. Also in this area, in vitro models play an important role to check disease-specific responses and to use them in drug screening. But also to monitor the drug bioavailability, therapeutic efficiency, and dose-limiting toxicity. Another important area in drug development is to analyze and to understand the side effects of drugs. For example, drug-induced liver injuries are a major source of clinical attrition, predictionary warnings, or post-market withdrawal. Accordingly, there is a need for more predictive tools to assess hepatotoxicity risk in drug discovery and therapeutic efficiency. Nowadays, there are several in vitro systems. Traditional 2D in vitro systems are commonly used, but these systems incompletely recapitulate the natural microenvironment. The cells in such 2D systems connect just to one or two other cells in the environment in one dimension. 3D models allow physical cell-cell and cell-extracellular matrix communication in every dimension. And therefore 3D cell culture models have become increasingly popular. There are several methods to culture cells in 3D, so you can embed your cells in a scaffold which provides them with an extracellular matrix. These are the so-called scaffold-based systems. But you can also culture the cells in non-scaffold-based systems, for example in spheroid cultures. And in these culture systems the cells show a natural shape, and it had been shown that the proliferation rate, the gene expression, and the signaling pathway activation were similar to in vivo conditions. Further, in such 3D systems you can build up multicellular systems, and such a 3D system can purchase the gap between in vitro and in vivo drug screening and possibly decrease the use of animal models. 3D models are used in preclinical studies and drug screening. There are key tools to understand diseases and to assess the potential efficiency of a new compound in drug discovery. Previous studies have shown that cells in a 3D environment activate typical signaling pathways of solid tumors and cancer-specific gene expressions, so these models can be used as disease models. But also cell function, behavior, and morphology were similar to what is seen in vivo. In the area of drug screening, a 3D network mimics tumor drug distribution gradient and resistance against chemotherapy better than 2D systems. But still, 3D models are not standardized in the lab. 3D models are a better predictor, but a standardization is needed. What kind of 3D cultures have the potential to be a standard assay in cell culture? If we have a look at the scaffold-based 3D culture, these model systems resemble the in vivo condition very nicely. So they have this extracellular matrix, but the production of such scaffolds is labor-intensive and expensive in preparation. Some of these models have undefined compositions like animal-derived proteins, and this has an impact on the predictability of your model. But also the scaffold can undergo structural changes over time, and this impacts the reproducibility of your results. Spheroids, in comparison, are 3D self-arranged cell clusters. Spheroids are simple in making. They are not expensive, so they're very cheap, and they provide reproducible data. Spheroids can recapitulate their tumor environment, which makes them a perfect model in cancer research. So they show a heterogeneous cell population which mimics the tumor microenvironment. Spheroids can also reproduce the mechanism of tumor initiation and spread. Spheroids are a perfect model for cancer research. And 3D spheroids cannot only be used in cancer research. Three-dimensional spheroids for hepatic culture have emerged as a promising tool to assess mechanisms of hepatotoxicity, to demonstrate enhanced liver phenotype metabolic activity and stability in culture, which was not obtainable with conventional two-dimensional hepatic models. The spheroids have a high potential to standardize the 3D culture in preclinical studies and drug screening. Here are different systems available to culture such spheroids, but they differ in the suitability as standardized systems for drug development, including high-throughput screening. For example, you can culture your cells on biologically inert surfaces which are cell and protein-repellent and force the cells to aggregate and form a spheroid. This technology is used in our BIOFLOAT plate, but you can also culture your spheroids in so-called spinner flasks, in which steered reservoirs are used to prevent cell adhesion to the surface of the plate, allowing 3D spheroid formation. Another method is the hanging drop method. In this method, the cells are seated in small drops of medium, and in this medium the cell forms aggregates due to the gravity force. Another method is the cultivation with microcarrier beads. In this method, the cells adhere to the microbeads, proliferate on the surface, and form 3D structures. The cultivation in spinner flask does not allow a high-throughput analysis in cell-based assays, and also the microcarrier beads can interfere with your cell assay in the high-throughput screening. In the image, we can observe the differences between the spheroids obtained by different methods. The cell line used in the image is a mouse fibroblast cell line. When we compare a low-adhesion plate with a hanging drop system, we can see that in the low-adhesion plate the spheroids are formed and show a round and regular morphology. In comparison to that, the cells in the hanging drop systems form spheroids with irregular shape and small cell satellites. Another big disadvantage of the hanging drop method is that it's not possible to replace the media or the drug during the experiment, which is important when you want to check the response of a drug for several days. The hanging drop system is a fragile system, and it's complicated to use, and it's not suitable for high-throughput screening. The hanging drop method has limited use in drug discovery. BIOFLOAT plates facilitate the rapid formation of uniformly shaped spheroids with consistent structure and functionality. So we showed a stable quality and performance of our plate. The main advantages of using biologically inert surfaces, which are cell and protein repellent, are as follows. Our BIOFLOAT plates are animal-free. They provide the freedom for the users to operate in 96 well and 384 well plates. And also use BIOFLOAT Flex solution for biochips and microfluidic devices. They're time-saving and easy to use, so they allow fast generation of spheroids for fast experimental setup. They are high-throughput compatible, and most importantly, they meet the three core requirements. They allow a rapid formation of spheroids. The spheroids are round and reproducible for perfect data consistency. They are reliable and robust. We at Facilitate provide low-adhesion plates for spheroid cultures. We provide three different products. The first is a pre-coated ready-to-use 96-well plate. The second is a pre-coated ready-to-use 384-well plate. And the BIOFLOAT Flex solution, which is an inert coating and is widely applicable to coat biochips, microfluidic devices, and bioreactors. Those products are animal-free and allow a faster time-saving generation of spheroids and give you reproducible results for a wide range of cell types. BIOFLOAT Plates promotes the rapid formation of round spheroids with consistent morphology and function. For more related information, please check our website facilitate.com.